Hello, folks. This is your host, Tammy Tuckey, and you are now listening to the Tiara Talk Show. We bring you rare interviews with the makers of Disney magic. Whether they be singers, actors, Imagineers, animators, they have all made their mark on the Disney name. Be sure to check out the show notes, other episodes, contests, our social media pages from Facebook to Twitter, and more on our official website at www.thetiaratalkshow.com. All guest opinions are theirs and theirs alone and do not represent the opinions of the Tiara Talk Show or the host. The Tiara Talk Show is not associated with the Disney Company. Thank you for tuning into this week's episode. And from all of us here at the Tiara Talk Show, have a hoop-de-doo day. I'm excited to welcome this week's Tiara Talk Show guest, Joyce Bulifant, to the show. Welcome, Joyce.
Thank you so much.
I'm really excited because I've always been a Happiest Millionaire fan, so to have you on the show, it's great.
You've been by jumping.
Oh, you can only imagine. But before we get into Disney, primarily you're working on promoting your book right now, which I got a copy of and I absolutely adored it. My Four Hollywood Husbands is what it's titled. And our listeners, I really do strongly encourage you to go ahead and check it out yourself. It will be in the show notes below, a direct link to go ahead and purchase a copy, including Joyce's website, so you can stay connected with her. But for me, I love that you included all of these images, you know, along with your story, of course, because I feel like, you know, it's great to see what you were actually seeing yourself during that time frame. And I can only imagine how crazy it must have been at your end just to go through the archives to see what you wanted to include.
It was really hard to decide which pictures to use. And I just tried to kind of use the picture at the point I was talking about it in the book, because I know so many people put their pictures right in the middle of the book. So you're reading along and then you want to see it. You go to the center and you go look for it. So I kind of tried to put it next to the story I was telling.
And you have so many amazing stories in this book, and I don't want to ruin it for everybody because I know a lot of us are going to go ahead and purchase our copies. But one of the primary stories I thought was very interesting was they were having a really difficult time casting your role, Rosemary, in The Happiest Millionaire.
Yes. And my friend was the writer of it. And, I had two little children then, and they were looking for a roommate who was 17 to be with Lesley Ann Warren. And at that time, I think I was 28, something like that. And I would go to dinner at their house, and AJ would be saying, "We're having the worst time finding the roommate for Lesley Ann." And I was kind of going under the table, "Oh, come on, pick me, you know, and... No, nothing, until I went to the celebrity, well, it wasn't a celebrity, it was a fundraiser for, I think, Cher, and Cher, S-H-A-R-E, for children, and Richard Sherman was sitting next to A.J. Carruthers, the writer, my friend, and I was sitting across the table, and he whispered to A.J., "Boy, there's our Rosemary, if she was only an actress." And AJ said, "She is an actress." And he said, "Well, we've got to get her to test that she's perfect." And there you go. That's how it happened.
And you had chemistry tests with Lesley. Did they get you all dressed up in the costumes and work from there? Like, how does that usually work on the original Walt Disney Studios backlot?
You know what? If this is terrible. I can't remember. I think we just did the scene. And unfortunately, when it was time, I did the scene with Lesley Ann. And when it was time for my close-up, on her close-up, I was there. When it was time for my close-up, she wasn't feeling well. She left. And I had to do it with the script supervisor.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it was a little difficult. But I did it. And I don't think they asked me. I don't think they asked me to sing. And if they didn't and they said, "Can you sing?" I probably told a story and said yes. And then you learn to do it if you get the role. And I went to take some singing classes. But when I went to the American Academy of Dramatic Arts, no one wanted me to take voice lessons because, and even later when I got a voice coach, they didn't want me to really learn to sing in the traditional way because they thought I would sound like everyone else and they liked the uniqueness of my voice. So it worked in some ways, but in other ways, I wish I had had formal voice training. I would be stronger. But my husband, Roger, he's been the best. He's a wonderful singer and composer, and he has helped me the very most of anyone. And then I went on singing after that. I mean, I did musicals and everything. So I'm always hesitant, but I feel a lot better now than I did then because I've learned more from Roger.
Well, I can't wait to hear you sing in the next couple of months. I'm very excited. It's like a dream come true for somebody. Like, see, that whole entire scene, I love it because that's what us girls do, you know. Everybody's like, what do you do for slumber parties? You know, dance around and sing and have fun. And it's like, that's exactly what we would do.
They really captured it, didn't they? And it was, I mean, it wasn't an easy dance at all. And I just had a baby. So I would go to the studio before I was hired. I'd sneak in. And for 2 weeks, I'd work with all the dancers at the bar just trying to get strong. Because Lesley Ann had been dancing professionally since she was 4, I think. So she was really good. And I was not, and I'm teaching her. It was sort of like Fred Astaire. When I work with Fred Astaire, he asked me to teach him a dance. And he said, what, Mr. Astaire? What do you mean? Because we had to do the twist together, and he didn't know how to do it. So I took him behind a flat on the studio, and I taught Fred Astaire the twist. That's my biggest claim to fame.
What I was told from a lot of different actors and actresses during that time frame of being on the Disney backlot is you never knew who you were going to see, especially Walt would come whenever he wanted. So did he ever come to any of the actual times that you were filming, either the ba-yum-pum-pum, you know, sleepover scene or the actual scene where you're dancing in the ballroom?
Well, he showed up a few times with visitors. And Lesley Ann kind of had a little bit of a sailor mouth at that time, I think because she was young and this was all kind of new to her. And I was always scared to death he'd come in when she was doing one of her sailor mouths because he was so proper and he would have just, that would have killed him. And he didn't. But when I was going, I talk about that in the book, when I was going to sing and record my part of Bayum Pum Pum, I was really nervous with a full orchestra. And I was walking down the street at Disney and out came Mr. Disney. I could never call him Walt or Uncle Walt. People asked him, he asked people to do that, but I just couldn't do it. I mean, he was Walt Disney, and I had to call him Mr. Disney. Anyway, he put his arm around me, and he said, I have big plans for you, little lady. And then he died. What he had in mind was A.J. Carruthers was working on a script for Lesley Ann and me to be guides at Disneyland. And John Davidson and Tommy Steele would be our boyfriends. Wouldn't that have been fun?
I love that idea. I'm so sad it didn't come to fruition because,
Am I just but now?
I could only imagine. See, now I'm just picturing how you guys are riding the Matterhorn or It's a Small World or Pirates.
Right, exactly. Wouldn't that have been fun, though? That would have been fun.
Did they ever think of bringing you in for the one and only genuine original family band? Because they had that Goldie Hawn role. She was supposed to be the blonde dancer with John Davidson at the end. And I just thought, hey, that would have, like to me, I thought, oh, that would have been Joyce's role.
Oh, that's very sweet. Maybe, but I was doing so many different television shows that I may not have been available. It's hard to imagine. Or I was going on location with my husband, James MacArthur. I always put family first. And so often, just as my movie career or television career was taking off, where I would be starring in a series or starring in a film, off I'd go with Jimmy to wherever he was filming. And that was number one to me, was to be with family. So, you know, everybody has different stories about what they feel successful about. And mm-hmm. mine, I hope, is finally making the right decisions for my children, which is in the book and was very difficult. But that's what I did.
Well, were you able to go back and find diaries that you had kept or little notes that would help jog your memory regarding certain events, you know, because sometimes I find it best to write down, you know, what happened during the week, because, hey, you never know who you meet and what happened that week in particular.
Well, I have pretty good recall on most things, mostly houses and what a room looked like and what colors were in there and things like that. But I didn't keep a diary really until 1993 or so. I started writing. I have incredible dreams. They're just wonderful in color and just they're terrific. But as far as taking notes and writing things down, I started doing a little bit of that when I was in boarding school, and I would be upset about something. I thought, well, if I write down why I'm upset, maybe it'll go away because I've written it down. You know, it didn't always go away, but it helped a lot always to write. And I seemed only to write when I was unhappy. Well, it took me 24 years to write the book. So that, you know, intermittently there were sad times and happy times and reflective times. And I hope it's helpful. I'm so pleased that people have come up to me, and I was so really afraid that people would say, why did you have to write this about this person? You know, that's nobody's business, and it's very personal, and blah, blah, blah. And that wasn't nice of you. And I was really afraid of that, because I really like to be liked, and that really worried me. But I thought, what's more important is for me to tell the truth in hopes that it will help other people. And so far, I've had the most wonderful, rewarding responses by people saying, thank you for sharing your story. It meant so much to me because I had this going on in my life. And one lady wrote to me and said, I was never married, but my relationships are so bad. And I'm going to go take a course on codependency just because of your book. And I thought, wow, it's doing just what I wanted it to. So that made me happy.
I'm glad it's having an emotional reaction with other, you know, readers, because you're going around on a book tour. And I do want to mention to our listeners that, hey, Joyce might be stopping where you're based. So go ahead and head to her website, which is in the show notes below. But I guess that there's that interaction that maybe that is a little bit more prominent today than it was back then. You really get to have like one-on-one conversations with fans. So are you finding that to be the best part about writing this book overall?
Oh, yes. That and letters I get and comments I get and the reviews on Amazon. It's got 5 stars. And I've read 12 of the reviews. And they're so heartwarming. And when I'm at bookstores and things, people, they don't want to just come over and shake hands and get the books. They say, can I give you a hug? I mean, it's like, well, yes, of course you can give me a hug. And this one elderly gentleman said, I just need to give you a kiss. And he kissed me on my forehead. It was so, I'm just overwhelmed. I'm grateful and overwhelmed. I really am.
And from this very busy book tour, you're going to be reprising your role as Rosemary alongside Lesley Ann Warren for a special benefit concert of The Happiest Millionaire. And this is a benefit for Broadway Cares on December 3rd, which I'll include in the show notes below a link to go ahead and purchase your tickets. I already got mine, as I already said, but I can only imagine how this is going to go.
You must come up and introduce yourself. I was over at the D23, the Disney convention, and everyone dresses up. My goodness, that was really something. And Whoopi interviewed a lot of us from The Happiest Millionaire. I just think it's so exciting. It's having this great rebirth. And if you go, I don't know if you've seen it, but on YouTube, somebody sent it to me. They have these two young men, and they are doing Bayum Pum Pum to Lesley Ann's and my voice. It is hysterical. It's one of the funniest things I've ever seen.
I can't wait till we have like this whole group. It's going to be like a party, I know for sure. But again, I want to make sure our listeners know, please buy Joyce's book. Check it out, because she has amazing stories, not only about Happiest Millionaire, but as she said, you know, with Fred Astaire. I read that one and I was just, you know, giggling because I love Fred Astaire, and there's other amazing stories, and it's an emotional journey. And I really, I'm so glad that you were very open about it, because not a lot of people, especially in this day and age, are very open about, you know, specific, you know, subjects like that. So again, in the show notes below, go ahead and purchase a copy of the book. And if you can make it on December 3rd in New York City to celebrate the Happiest Millionaire's 50th anniversary with the Broadway Cares benefit concert, the link is also in the description. So, and before we end, I have three Disney themed questions I ask each guest who comes on the show. So they're called the Fab Three. So the Donald one is, as a child, what Disney film was one of your favorites to see in the movie theater?
Oh, I think my favorite was Dumbo. But the very first film I ever saw in my life was Bambi. And I was about four, and I'll never forget. I was so sad. It was the saddest film.
And our goofy question, what Disney character do you think would be your best friend if you met them in person?
Oh, that's a great question. Dopey. Because I'd relate.
And finally, our Mickey question. If I asked you to name any Disney song at this very moment, what immediately comes to mind?
Someday My Prince Will Come.
I just want to thank you so much for being on the show, Joyce. I only wish you the best of luck with this book. Obviously, it's very, very successful. I'm so happy it is, and I'm so glad I got the chance to read it, and I can't wait to finally meet you soon.
Well, good. I look forward to it December 3rd.
As you secretly conceal the tingly way you feel when you're dancing to Bayum Pum Pum, Bayum Pum Pum, Bayum Pum.
Bayum pum pum.